Hello, it's ChewDog Charts, and today we're going to take a look at three dividend stocks. Actually, two dividend stocks and one REIT. However, they all pay money. Let's take a look. The first stock we're going to look at today is Investors Bancor, symbol ISBC. Now, for disclosure purposes, I do not hold any position in any of these stocks we're going to talk about today, either long or short. Now, ISBC was founded in 1926 and headquartered in Short Hills, New Jersey. ISB is the holding company for Investors Bank. It provides community banking products and services to individuals and businesses primarily in the New Jersey and New York areas. ISBC offers traditional deposit products and a portfolio of loan products. Now, recently, the company increased its quarterly dividend by 12.5% from 8 cents per share to 9 cents per share. The new dividend is payable on November 24th. Now, before we go and look at the charts, let's take a look at the dividend history. This chart shows the dividend history of ISBC going back to the second quarter of 2015, where we see that the quarterly dividend at that time was 5 cents a share. It remained level until the fourth quarter of 2015. In the first quarter of 2016, the dividend was raised to 6 cents per share. That remained until the fourth quarter of 2016, when it was increased to 8 cents a share. And that remained level until recently. The dividend was increased to 9 cents per share in the fourth quarter. So now let's take a look at the chart. Looking at the price chart for Investors Bancorp, we see that the stock had the typical decline in 2009 along with the rest of the market. However, since then, it's increased fairly steadily through 2015 with a slight consolidation here in the 2016 timeframe, but then has resumed a general upward trend to the current price of $13.77. Moving down to the MACD, we see that again the bottom here in 2009 with the increase into 2015 and the 2016 when it had a correction, and right now it has a slight downtrend that appears to be continuing. So that's something we're going to have to watch out for. That is shown in the histogram. However, in the histogram, it looks like we are trying to stabilize here and perhaps maybe even move up a slight bit. In the relative strength, we're at a moderate level of 60.10. And it looks like the stock has trended mostly over the 50-line midline since 2010 into the stochastic. The stochastic shows currently we're having a little bit of trouble with the fast line that went through the slow line or the trigger line. And it looks like it may want to try to head back up through the trigger line. But we're going to have to wait a little bit of time to see if that is actually going to be the case. The volume looks to be reasonable, and the Williams as well. The Williams shows that it wants to try to stay near the midline and perhaps have a reflection upward. Perhaps the dividend increase will help the stock gain the steam in order to start back on an upward trend. This looks to be pretty favorable. However, I'm not making a recommendation here at this time. You as an investor should take a look at the chart, but follow up on all the fundamental information before you buy. But it looks like a fairly decent candidate for potential investors. The next stock we're going to take a look at actually is a REIT, is Tanger Factory Outlet Centers. The symbol is SKT. Now, Tanger Factory Outlets is a retail-focused REIT, so there should be some caution for investors given the current condition of the real estate retail market. However, Tanger Factory Outlets owns 43 outlet centers that are spread across North America. The centers attract consumers by offering big discounts on name brand merchandise. Given the huge discount, consumers tend to shop there in good times as well as in bad. The same center net operating income growth has remained positive for more than a decade, including throughout the entirety of the 2008-2009 financial crisis. Occupancy rates have remained above 95% for more than 24 straight years. Further, Tanger has increased its annual dividend payment every year since going public in 1993. So let's go ahead and take a look at the dividends. So as we can see here by the dividend chart, back in early 2015, the dividend was 29 cents a share, which remained through the first quarter of 2016. In the second quarter of 2016, the dividend was increased to 33 cents a share. That remained level until the second quarter of 2017, where it has remained at 34 cents a share. So a relatively decent level with increases along the way. So now let's go back and take a look at the chart. Looking here at the chart, we can see that given the nature of the retail real estate market, Tanger Factory Outlet Centers, the price has taken a decline from the level here, low mid-40 dollars per share, down to the current price of $22.46 a share. That's a healthy cut in the price. Looking here at the MACD, we can see that the decline actually started here in 2013, and we have yet to bottom, though this recent decline looks like it's worse than the 2008-2009 financial crisis, where we were at that level. Moving down, the histogram shows, of course, a deep decline as well. Moving into the relative strength, looks like the relative strength index wants to try to bottom here at the oversold level of around 20. Moving further down into the stochastic, it looks like the stochastic is attempting to curve and bottom here, but hasn't yet. Looks like the RSI looks to be a leading indicator in that sense. Moving further down into the Williams as well wants to do some bottoming. It's done some sawtoothing here at near negative 100. So back up to the price chart. This is perhaps a REIT that you can keep on your list, but it's not quite ready. I'd like to see a little bit more consolidation down here and perhaps sideways movement. We did that here in 2008-2009 for almost a year. I'm not sure if we need a year here, but certainly we need some more time to make sure that the stock has bottomed, and I'd like to see some of the oscillators have improvements as well. So now let's take a look at the next stock. The next stock we're taking a look at here is Aflac Inc. The symbol is AFL. And Aflac was founded back in 1955 and is based in Columbus, Georgia. It's a supplemental health and life insurance company that operates in the USA and in Japan. In the USA, the company sells health and disability insurance, mainly as part of employer-sponsored group insurance plans. In Japan, AFL provides health insurance, life insurance, and annuity products. The company declared a quarterly dividend of 45 cents per share, which is an increase of 4.65% over the prior quarterly dividend. The first payment will be on December 1st. So let's go ahead and take a look at the dividend chart. Looking at the dividend chart, the dividend was 39 cents a share in the second quarter of 2015, increasing to 41 cents a share in the fourth quarter of 2015, remaining until an increase to 43 cents a share in the fourth quarter of 2016, and that has remained level until recently it was increased to 45 cents a share here. So now let's go ahead and take a look at the chart. Aflac had a very steep decline in the 2008-2009 financial crisis, but has rebounded significantly since then, from a price just over $10 a share up to the current price of $83.98 a share. So extremely positive for shareholders that held through that period of time. Moving on down to the MACD, it looks like we're in an uptrend that began, say, in 2016 and is continuing. The MACD histogram shows the same. The relative strength is starting to reach to a lofty level of 79.46. Basically, once a stock reaches over the 80 level in the RSI, often people consider that to be overbought. But it's not quite there, but it's knocking on the door. With regard to the stochastics, we're also in lofty levels. We've had a period of time here, almost a year and a half, above 80. And looking back at the past history, it has stayed above 80 for over a year and a half here. Also here, about a year and a half. This was somewhat around a year. So this extended period of time that we've had here may be getting a little bit too long. So moving down here, we'll take a look at the Williams. It doesn't really show us too much, although it does indicate we've held above 20 for a relatively extended period of time as well. Going back to the actual price, it looks like Aflac, especially with the increased dividend, may have some more upside, but given the nature of some of these oscillators, it's something that I'd like to sit back and wait for some consolidation. Again, all three stocks, I do not hold any positions, and I'm not giving any actual buy recommendations. What I am recommending is that you take a look at the price charts, but do your proper follow-up in the fundamental analysis, particularly the earnings and the dividends. So for now, that's ChewDog Charts. Thank you.